Peace, everybody. This is Queen Ifama. I'm a truth terrorist, and I'm doing this lunch hour video today. And today, I thought I would talk a little bit about relationships. And I think that from this point forward, I'll be sharing some things about my relationships and my experiences and stuff. And the reason I'm doing this is because I was speaking with a sister today who was telling me how she had, her and a friend of hers, had ran across these two younger women, and they told them that they look like sisters, but they're not sisters, and the circumstances that drew them together was very interesting. And the young women asked them, that told them that they should write a book about it, and that more of us older women should share our experiences. And that they ain't all pretty either, and they're not all triumphal, but I think that either they'll help you avoid some pitfalls, or they will strengthen hope in you that there is some hope out there to have a positive relationship with a black man. And the what I want to talk about today is that I'm a Pan-Africanist, black nationalist, African woman of Africa, a black woman of African descent. So that's how I identify myself. And the circles that I travel in generally are some of that. You know, even you can include Afrocentrists in there, because those Egyptology kind of people, right? That always love to talk about Kemet. Okay, so, you know, those are the circles that I generally travel in. And I travel in those circles because even though they can be as fucked up too, they do have a semblance of the principles of my aunt. And they try, you know, within their capacity to uphold, you know, the civility and all of those things within those parameters. But, you know, what I've noticed is, and I have like several brothers who I respect and in my community, and knowing them all the years that I've known them, they have not been able to keep a woman. Now, prior, I didn't really know some of the women that they messed around with or had relationships with, but lately, there are a couple who have women that I know, and I know these women, and I know what type of women they are. So, you know, my question is, why is it so hard? And I think Brother Polite kind of, you know, talked about that on a video on Brother Sarnetta's channel, is about these brothers who are out in the community, pro-black, pro-nationalist, and they can't keep a woman. You don't see them with a woman. They don't have a woman. You know what I'm saying? And the ones I know can't seem to keep one. They go from relationship to relationship, and some you don't even know if they're in a relationship at all. And so, you know, I know what kind of woman I am. And like I say, I don't change and be something different from who I really am, you know, when I meet a man. You know what I'm saying? I am who I am. And generally, you know, they pretend like they accept who I am from the giddy up. But after a while, they want to shape and mold me into being something that I'm not. And, you know, I'm not. Like I said, I ain't the wifey type. You know, if that's what you're looking for, this quote-unquote wifey type of woman, I'm not that type of woman. You know, I don't enjoy cooking and cleaning and shit. I don't enjoy that. You know what I'm saying? Now, I'll do it, but it's not something I enjoy. You know what I mean? And if that's the type of woman you want, I'm not that type. But... and I'm not trying to hold no man definitely with my cooking, you know. But, you know, I just think that I just find it interesting that, you know, you hear sisters whining and crying about they can't find a good man. And then you got all these nationalist black, pro-black brothers, and they claiming they can't find a good woman and all this. And I know I'm a good woman. I don't give a damn what nobody say. And these sisters that I know who have been in a relationship with these black nationalists, these pro-black brothers, and I know what type of women they are, because they're friends of mine, so I know what type of women they are, you know. But it's something, I don't know what these brothers expect, or how they expect us to be, you know, because it seems like they can't be on an even level with us. They want to be up here, and they want us to be down here. And, you know, I was listening to what's his name? Manning Marable's account of Malcolm. And there's a certain mentality amongst these so-called pro-black brothers. And if you get an opportunity and you can read that book that Marable Manning or whatever his name is, that he has out. I listened to the audio book of it because I don't have, you know, a lot of time to read, sit down reading. That's one of those things that I like to go listen to, and audio books are great for that. And so, just listening to that, there's a mentality that came out of that era that persists today. And even Malcolm's thoughts, and nobody really talks about Malcolm's thoughts about women, you know, how he really saw women, and words out of his own mouth as to what he thought about women and their place. You know what I'm saying? I think everybody has their roles, okay? And I think that, excuse me, I just had a little piece of lunch, but not much. And I think that these roles have to be agreed upon. They cannot be assumed. And I think that is what happens, is that sometimes sisters have an idea of a role that a brother is supposed to be in. That's an assumption. It's not an agreed upon role. And brothers have a role that sisters are supposed to be in according to their thought processes. But it's not agreed upon, because I'm going to tell you, in all the relationships and the two husbands that I've had, my first husband, he was pretty cool with that. Even my second husband, he had to adjust, because I don't bend, you know, I don't bend, particularly in do things that I don't find pleasant. Now, I'll cook every now and then, but I'm not going to do all the cooking. You know, I'll clean, but I'm not going to do all the cleaning, particularly if I'm doing eight and you're doing eight too. That was like a little bug flying around. And you're doing eight too. You know what I mean? I'm in the cafeteria down here, so you might see little bugs falling around. Fruit flies, they call them. And perhaps I should cover up my food here, because anyway, I better put another cover on it, right? I don't want no little critters on my stuff. But anyway... But anyway, so I think that those roles have to be agreed upon. And like I was saying with my husband, my first husband, see, it's so many things that I didn't know that I know now. And I knew that he was a good man. And I knew that he did love me. But at that particular time, he wasn't fast enough for me. Because, you know, I'm from the street. So, you know, we got together. I met him in the street. But he was square as a pool table and twice as green. But, you know, we kind of got thrown together. So he really wasn't my first choice. He wasn't a man I would have chosen. But we kind of got thrown together, and then we got married, you know, pressurized to get married. I was around 18, pressurized to get married, but I wasn't really happy with him because he wasn't fast enough. But now I wish for that kind of man, you know, that kind of, you know, easygoing, you know, brother who really loved me. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, I just found something so much better, so much more interesting, who turned out not to be shit, just to put that on record. But anyway, you know, what I'm trying to say is that I don't understand, you know, why we in the so-called Pan-Africanist, black nationalist, pro-black, know everything, know all the psychological damage, and know how the system has done the black man, and know how the system has done the black woman, why we can't seem to come together to be an example to our younger brothers and sisters. You know, these younger brothers and sisters, when they see us, we by ourselves. We ain't with a mate. We ain't suited up. We ain't hooked up, you know, but we talking all that shit. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, and they got flies up in here too. Golly. But anyway, I digress. But anyway, you know, I've been really thinking about that for the past few days, because I was at an event, and all the brothers that I respect, they don't have no woman. They can't keep a woman. And And, you know, it just, and one of them was accused of beating his women, you know, and the other one, I know for a fact, he just dropped a good woman for pure D nothing. Pure D nothing. I mean, it's nothing to me, because he told me what, you know, why he was having reservations, you know, and it's all physical. You know what I'm saying? And it's not that, you know, she's a very beautiful, beautiful woman, very elegant, nice looking, dressed nice, professional, everything. She just doesn't turn me on. I'm like, she got all the qualities that a man would want, and you want to be turned on. Isn't that ridiculous? This is a elder brother in the community. You know, and this woman is gorgeous. You know, clean, on her own property, got her own, you know, she's got her own career going on. She make nice bank. She's intelligent. She's black, pro-black. She may not be a Pan-Africanist or a black nationalist or call herself that, but she does say she's pro-black, okay? And she work on behalf of black children, okay? For the most part, in the capacity that she actually earns her living in, all right? So, you know, I find it difficult and hard for me to have respect for these brothers over a period of time, because I keep seeing them blowing it, you know, and even in my own relationships, I know what kind of woman I am, and I know that I'm not, I mean, I'm gonna put it like this. If a brother really, really accepted me as I am, he wouldn't have any problems with me, because I don't have a problem with sharing. I don't be bugging a nigga for nothing. I don't ask a black man for nothing. As a matter of fact, I'm willing to share what I have. You know what I'm saying? But I don't know what these men expect, these black nationalist men. But like I said, I think it's coming out of that black nationalist era with Malcolm X. And like I said, you got to read because his biography says some things that he penned with Alex Haley, I think. But if you read that, if you listen to or get the book by Manning Marable, I can't think of Manning Marable, whatever his name is, I keep saying it wrong. But if you get it and you listen to some of the quotes that he's got out from Malcolm, okay, words Malcolm has actually said about women, when I heard it, I said, this is how these brothers actually think. You know, and when you got a woman that has her own, that's intelligent, that has read as many books as you have, that has come to more conclusions than you about the state of black people as you have, that you are on an intellectual par with, that you are intellectually on par with. It ain't like you could teach her, you know, because I think what it is that they're looking for, probably, maybe, perhaps, I don't know, I could be wrong, but maybe they're looking for women that they can teach, that they can mold, that they can, you know, teach something. Because when you stand with a woman that can go toe-to-toe with you intellectually, that know as much theory as you do, that can quote as many authors and scholars as you can, I think they got a problem with that. You know, when you can have debate on ideology with your woman, it's some men don't want no debate. They want to be the end all, know all of everything, you see? And I think that could be the crux of the situation. And that's why, even though, you know, people have problems with Brother Polite, I can say that, you know, just, and I'm only going by a damn video, and when they came to Milwaukee and did a presentation, is I don't see low self-esteem in them women. You know what I'm saying? And they seem to be very confident to me, and what they're doing is, though, they know exactly what they're doing, and he doesn't seem domineering and overpowering and, you know, all that. He's the spokesperson. He's the head of their household, and they respect him for that, but he also respects them for what they do and what they know. You know, and one time I think I saw a video where they actually spoke. So, you know, I just think that, and he's a younger brother, you know what I'm saying? I think these older cats, and because that's the only pool I will date out of, you know, I'm kind of like in limbo, you know, because I talked to a 45-year-old guy the other day who was trying to get next to me, and I just can't do it. You know, I can't do it. You know, so my pool is a little jaded, and I think it comes from that era, from studying and behind Malcolm and the Nation of Islam, because I think they had a precedent mindset of men. And literally, you know, I'm telling you, and when I look, oh God, I have so much I want to say to you, because, you know, there are so, and now, as I go through the YouTube, I see so much animosity, you know what I'm saying? And I wish I could do a poll and do some ages, because I would like to know the ages of these brothers. I mean, you got brothers with whole websites dedicated to hating black women. Seriously, it's the saddest thing I've ever seen. And I'm wondering, you know, I've always been trying to figure out, what is the problem? Why is this? You know, what has a woman done so much that you would hate all of them? What has a man done so much to you that you could hate all of them? You know, I've been in some pretty bad relationships. You know, I can count them on these hands in my lifetime. You know, whether they were long-term or just some short-term flings. And I can say that even though they didn't turn out well, and these people didn't turn out to be not my caliber of individual, I can truly say that that don't make me hate men. That don't make me hate black men. That don't make me want to go over to the other side and, well, I guess I'll go get me a Puerto Rican man. I'll go get me a white man. That ain't never crossed my mind. Even though black men, I think those I've had have not been right. You know, they haven't been right with me. And in some cases, in one case in particular, I wasn't right with him. You know, but that don't make me hate black men. That don't make me kick all black men to the curb. It makes me wary, but it doesn't make me kick them to the curb. I'm always open for that righteous black man, that good black man that knows and understands when he has a good woman. You know what I'm saying? Because I think they're intimidated sometimes by our intelligence, some of us. You know what I mean? I've been trying to understand the dynamic, you know, so, and to voice this, you know, you get a lot of hate mail. I know I'm gonna get a whole lot of hate comments on this particular subject, but, you know, I really don't care, you know what I'm saying? Because that's their opinion, but I'm just trying to figure it out. I'm just trying to figure out exactly what, particularly men in my generation, because those are the only ones I'm interested in, is what is it? You know, why these older brothers ain't got no woman? Why so long in their life they are alone? What's really going on? I mean, I'm just curious as to what it is, because I know many sisters are looking for brothers who are Pan-Africanists, who say they love black queens, and oh, that's what these brothers be talking to. Oh, they love the black woman. She's a queen. She's a god. She's a goddess. She's all this. But when you get a queen, a god, or a goddess, you don't know how to treat her because you have certain roles that you have put in your head that she's supposed to be fulfilling without her consent. And that could apply to some sisters too. Why you, and I'm guilty, because I feel that men are supposed to, you know, do certain things, but, you know, I like to ask them, well, do you like to do that? You know what I'm saying? And they at first say, yeah, they willing to do anything at first. That's the representative. Just to put that on record, I talked about it on another video. The representative, that's the representative. You see, but they think just like we do, women, that they can get in there and change you. That you will mold and you, that you will break down and be what they want you to be for them. In other words, you will have to literally shut the fuck up. Period. No, having no intellectual debates with them, no opinion differences, differences with them. You're the yes man or the yes woman for them. I'm telling you, that's what I'm seeing. And it's something that I really would like to explore and, you know, try to figure out. Because I know it's some younger sisters who go get to my age, and I don't want them to be sitting around thinking the same shit. I think you need to challenge them brothers right now. You know, because if you're smart and you're intelligent and you study and you read too, I can see if you don't and you want to, he's your teacher. But some of us don't need a teacher. As a matter of fact, we can teach them a few things. Okay, because we have another perspective as women. But they don't respect, and this is what I'm saying from my experience and what I'm seeing, is that they have a lack of respect for our understanding and our knowledge. That's what I'm getting. We're supposed to be quiet. We're supposed to be chaste and quiet and have our heads bowed and, you know, all that Muslim shit. And you ain't no Muslim, okay? And I ain't no Muslim. And see, that's why I ain't gonna be one, because I ain't like that. I can't be like that. You know what I'm saying? Sister Betty wasn't even like that, all right? Malcolm's wife, all right? But you got to read that book, because they give a whole different account of that whole situation. You know what I'm saying? They give a whole different account from Malcolm's perspective, too. So it ain't just something they making up, all right? But anyway, I just wanted to do this video, because I'm going to go take my lunch and eat it at my desk. Now lunch hour's over. But I just wanted to talk about that. I want to talk about relationships, because I think that our young brothers and sisters need to know, you know, about our relationship, particularly those of us who consider ourselves Black nationalists. Why don't we have successful relationships? We know all about my aunt. We know all about the white man, and we know all about white supremacy, and we know all about discrimination and racism and all of that stuff. Oh, we can rattle that shit off, honey. But why come we can't keep a man, and why come we can't keep a woman? That's what I want to talk about. Why can't we keep one? Old as our asses are, we old and alone. And you see a bunch of them walking around in their 70s and 80s, ain't got nobody. With long locks, they've been growing them for years. They got the African stuff on. They got all the jewelry they've been wearing for years and years and years. But they can't keep a mate. What is up with that? Now, this is for my young people. You'll question us, what is up with that? You know, so that you don't wind up like that. That's why I'm doing this video. So with that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist. We're going to explore this shit, okay? And I'm just going to relay my experiences and my ideas about it. I don't have to be right on my ideas or my thoughts about it, but I will be right on my experience and how I feel about those experiences. I will be right on that. Okay, but, you know, when it comes to trying to find a solution, I'm looking for one just like you are, because I want a Black man. But I want a man on my level. My past second husband, he was not on my level intellectually, psychologically, or, you know, as far as culturally, he was not on my level. I had surpassed him. See, when we met, I was studying. And then as we, you know, kept, I was still studying. He never was into that. I was, you know, so we was always kind of like out of sync. And, you know, I was always involved in community activities and things. And he wasn't, and he resented me for that. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, we're going to have conversation about that, people. And you're invited to do response videos on it and give your commentary. I just think we need to have a really honest discussion without the blame type of thing. You know what I'm saying? Because something ain't right when your quote-unquote elders, which y'all call elders, I call them your olders, when your quote-unquote elders don't have nobody. and they old and they talking about they black nationalists. What's up with that? So with that said, this is Queen Ifama, and I'll see you at the next video. Peace, everybody. Have a good one. Love yourself. Bye.